So good morning. Today we'll actually try to digest some of the concepts which we have discussed and you have studied. More specifically, we'll discuss some multiple choice questions, and then probably after more lectures, some problem also you know how to solve, and we have seen regarding transformation and all. We'll discuss more about that, but right now some multiple choice question, let us discuss. First question, if Puma like industrial robots, all joints are freezed by say welding, right? Welding is an operation, joining operation, right? Those not mechanical engineers should know. So how many degrees of freedom the structure has when it is placed on a floor to the surface, right? Plane floor. So this is our Puma robot, and suppose all the joints are fixed, okay? All the joints are fixed. This is fixed, okay? This is fixed. All the joints are fixed, you know. Then how many degrees of freedom it will have? 1, 3, 5, 6. You are right. Correct answer is 3. Why? Because when it is completely freezed, it will act as a solid body. Okay. And when a solid body is kept on a 2D surface, it can have only 3 degrees of freedom. What are those 3 degrees of freedom? Translation about X, translation about Y, and rotation about Z. So nothing else can happen. Okay? So that's the answer. Correct answer is B, 3. Now, second question is, for a manipulating robot, matrix transformation from joint space to Cartesian space is, the mapping is onto, 1-to-1, it is 1-to-1 and onto, it is 1-to-1 or onto. So this is a set theory which perhaps you know. Say I have Cartesian space denoted by X, maybe X1, X2, X3, X4, X5, X6, and I have a joint space, right, theta. So by this time you know you are coming from transforming from joint space to Cartesian space. So this is basically a forward pose kinematics problem, right? And what will be the answer? 1-to-1. Why? Because you see, the transformation from range space N to range space M is 1-to-1, because for every vector V in the range space N, the equation Tx equals to V has at most one solution in X in the range space of M. That means for any element in this set, joint space, joint set, there could be at most, not more than one, okay? At most one element in the Cartesian space. So, first answer B is the correct, 1-to-1. The transformation is called 1-to-1. For other onto and all, you can just see what they are, right? There should be at least one solution if it has to be onto. Third question, a manipulating robot having a signature RRPPRP, okay? So you know how to read signature. R is for revolute joint. And P is for prismatic joint. Prismatic joint. Huh? Now you see, it has RR, 2R, right? 1-to-2P, okay? So 2P and then followed by R and followed by P. Very easy. Yeah. So 1-to-3R. So 3 revolute joint, so answer is 3 revolute joint or 3 prismatic joint, 6 joints, 3 revolute joint and 3 prismatic joint. Definitely this is correct. 3 revolute joint, as this is a manipulator signature, and 3 prismatic joint. That's the correct answer. Now come to question number 4. To get closed form inverse kinematic solutions for a manipulating robot, following Piper's recommendation is a sufficient condition, necessary condition, necessary and sufficient condition, neither necessary nor sufficient. So which one is correct? You see, Piper in 1968, D. Piper, he wrote a PhD thesis in Stanford University, actually analyzing the serial kinematic chains closed form solution condition, right? And then he showed that if in a serial kinematic chain, any 3 consecutive joint axes, if they are intersecting, joint axes are intersecting at a point, then the closed form kinematic solution, inverse pose solution, closed form inverse pose kinematic solution will be guaranteed. So it is not necessary, but it is sufficient condition. That means you may violate his condition, but still can crank out closed form solution. And closed form solution, numerical solution, you know, right? Say, what is a closed form solution? Example is, in mathematics, x square plus 2ax minus 3 equal to 0. So this is a quadratic equation. It will have always a closed form solution. The 2 roots will be, you know, it's got minus 4ac, okay. It will be imaginary roots, fine, okay. Otherwise, you can put it plus, so it will be 4a into c, by 2, okay. So this is a definition, this is definition of closed form solution. Okay. But what if the equation is like this? You cannot find closed form solution. Then you will have to use Newton-Raphson method, and you will need to figure out numerically what will be the value of x which can satisfy this equation. So closed form solution is non-iterative, which is desirable in case of robotics, because the solution becomes very quick. But in case of numerical solution, it is iterative in nature. You need to follow a lot of iterations, and there are a little bit numerical error, it's approximate solution, okay? So this is closed form kinematic solution. So here, Piper recommendation will be sufficient. So question, the correct answer will be A, sufficient condition. If somebody, to get a closed form inverse kinematic solution, if somebody obeys Piper's recommendation. Next question, for modeling robot manipulator having a single degree of freedom per joint, we use Dinovate-Hartenberg parameters. Out of 4 parameters, which one is correct? One is geometric parameter and 3 are motion parameter. 2 are motion parameter, 2 are geometric parameter. 1 is motion parameter and 3 are geometric parameters. All 4 are motion parameters. So if you have studied my lectures on DH parameters, you know that out of 4 DH parameters, 3 are geometric parameter. Okay, they never changes with motion. Okay, once the robot is designed, that is, the design is given, okay, all those parameters are actually fixed. For example, if it is Revolut type of robot like Puma, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? Puma has all 6 Revolut joint. And between 2 successive joint, it will have DH parameters. What are those DH parameters? DH parameters actually, as you know, one is motion parameter about Z axis. Then the distance between 2 successive common normal, which is denoted by DI, okay? And the common normal, which is the minimum distance between 2 successive Z axis, okay? And the twist angle, the angle between 2 successive Z axis, which is measured about X, okay? So in case of any robot, if it is Revolut robot, then all DI, AI minus 1, alpha A minus 1, they are fixed, the geometric parameter. Only one parameter, theta, which is Revolut joint, which will be a variable. But in case of prismatic robot, say some prismatic robot, PP type, they are DI, the distance between 2 successive common normal will be the variable. Okay, so here the correct answer is, three are geometric parameter, one motion parameter. Which one? So one is motion parameter and three is geometric parameter. So this is the correct answer, answer C, okay? Now function arctan 2 y comma x and tan inverse y divided by x, both are same. The second function is a 2-argument arctan function. The first function is 2-argument arctan function. Both can be used for finding inverse kinematics solution. Okay? So, you see, which one is correct? You know, I have illustrated in my lecture, say, in a 2D, you have 2 orthogonal axes. This is first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant, and the simple arctan function, suppose you have a point like minus 1, point like 4 comma 4. So what will be this angle? 4 comma 4 here. So this is 4 comma 4. The angle will be pi by 4 or the 45 degree, right? 45 degree angle. Now, if the point is in the third quadrant, minus 4, minus 4, then it should have been this, right? The 180 plus 45, that means 225 plus 225 degree, right? Or minus 135 degree, same, both are same. So it should have been like that, okay? But your arctan will give still pi by 4, because tan inverse, it will calculate minus 4 divided by minus 4, okay? That is pi by 4. That's why it's a problematic, right? So we modify a little bit to the arctan function by taking care of the argument of the variables you are passing to the function. So the correct answer is the first function is a 2-argument arctan function. So this is different. A tan 2 function is different. A tan 2 function is different. A tan 2 is not equal to tan inverse function. Okay. Arctan 2. 2 means it takes care of the argument of the 2 variables. Okay. So this is the correct answer. Okay. For a robot gripper, next question is, whose 3 successive joint intersect at a point, orientation description using Euler angle, the gimbal lock situation occurs when, I have a number of videos which is describing gimbal lock situation, you know. So, you know, so which one is correct? What is gimbal lock situation? As you know, the orientation required 3 orthogonal axes to represent correctly orientation, right? Or orientation, right? So that is, if three Z axis, for example, an aircraft, okay? Aircraft, a fighter aircraft, vertical, right? So it has yaw, pitch and roll. You see, this is yaw. So this is the yaw axis. It becomes vertical and it coincides with the roll axis, okay? Or roll axis coinciding with pitch axis, fighter plane, or and in case of gripper manipulator also, when two successive joint axis are overlapping, then what? Then 3 degrees of freedom is lost, and mathematically you can see the rotation matrix will be, determinant will be zero, and it will be non-invertible, right? So it will, mathematically we call it, the matrix is of not full rank. So it should have been 3 rank, a rotation matrix, right? So it will have less than 2 rank. In that situation, we call gimbal lock situation, okay? Gimbal lock situation, the object loses 1 degree of freedom, and imagine, if my robot gripper or the aircraft is in gimbal lock situation, then its inversion will not exist, and then control torque for that orientation cannot be generated. So that's the problem with Euler angle representation. Okay. So the correct answer is any two joint axes are actually coincide. Okay. This is the correct answer. When this thing happens, gimbal lock will happen. Okay, you can just have any rotation matrix and just see this. You can inject gimbal lock situation. Okay, you will see this will happen only. I have actually in the lecture note, I have a concrete example how to solve gimbal lock situation.